10, decline isn't always the end.
We would like to share two stories with you. 4 years ago, we were looking for an engineering manager for our customer. He took part in two meetings and he was invited for the third and for the last one. However, in the meantime, he got the offer from his previous employer and he was under time pressure, so he decided to accept it and decline our final interview. We convinced him to go to the interview anyway and not to cancel it. He followed our advice. The company was enthusiastic about him and he started to be enthusiastic about them as well. In the end, he got the offer and accepted it. He works for this customer until today.
Another story concerns a developer who got the offer from our customer and decided to decline it. He gave us some reasons, but we didn't believe it. We are digging, but he didn't want to give us the real reason. In the end, it turned out that he was worried about working with the hiring manager. We are surprised because the manager made a good impression on other candidates. So we consulted his aspect with the HR department and they confirmed that on that day, the manager had simply a bad day. So we decided to organize one more meeting, and during this meeting, the manager was acting normal as on almost every other day, and the candidate changed his mind and finally decided to accept the offer.
You might think, why convince someone who doesn't want to work? Well, because the reasons for rejection may be various. In the first case, the manager rejected the offer not because he didn't like it, but because he was looking for the job and he finally wanted to start working. Was it the right decision? Time has confirmed it because the cooperation continues until today.
In the second case, the candidate made the decision based on bad premises. Everyone is entitled to a worse day, even the best manager. If everything else was positive, was it worth giving up such cooperation because one bad day? I don't think so. So decline is not always the end.